Dude.
Woo! Horror mud is when people play tricks on each other. It's all make believe.
I saw the boogeyman. I saw him outside.
I'm a staff writer for Vulture and a film and TV critic, and my guest needs no introduction.
Well, I might need a little.
This is Jamie Lee Curtis.
Yeah! Yeah!
Who holds many records, including, I believe, playing the
long 78. I remember everything about that day. So for me, the past is simply a little trigger memory, but I don't have the perspective of it. I just don't think I will. I'll be dead, and then there'll be perspective. Seriously, that's, and then people will write shit, and then Heidi will write things about me. And my life with Jamie for 50 years or 60 years or whatever we are lucky enough to have.
Do you mind watching yourself in the finished product? Because I know some performers don't.
I don't dwell on it. I don't ever watch something again. Like, I would never, like, go home today and go, like, I'm going to watch Freaky Friday. Just going to watch it. I heard the little clip. I don't have a problem with it. I don't have a problem with it. I'm excited by it. I saw Everything Everywhere All at Once for the first time at the world premiere at... in Austin, Texas. Thank you, Heidi. Heidi, by the way, Heidi Schaefer, we've known each other for how long, Heidi? Heidi has been my publicist for
how long?
Heidi Schaefer and I went, Heidi Schaefer was a junior publicist at PMK. Who here? I wish I had a, do I have a prize or anything? Do we have like, normally these things are like 7 minutes.
We have a countdown timer that looks like it's on a bomb at a James
Bond. It's not a good feeling, you guys. Wow.
So let's.
Wow, and you're not sweating or anything, although you cut yourself shaving.
I did, damn. I was hoping that.
What, we wouldn't notice it?
Well, you know, the audience.
The audience sees this side. So you
he
just,
has a cut on his face. He cut himself shaving. See?
Aww.
And you got them on my side, so I appreciate that.
Well, of course they're on your side. If we're not on each other's side at this point, on a beautiful Saturday afternoon in Los Angeles. We're all just trying to figure out what the fuck's going on. We're trying to figure out how to manifest our destinies, how to wake up, be better people, be creatives, try to have some fun before we die. Seriously. Okay.
Yeah, so anyway.
There she is.
Okay, so here we are. Anthony Perkins, Janet Leigh, and Psycho, in a happy moment. Not very many in that movie. What did she say when you told her that you got in this part?
Honestly, there's nothing there. I think she was happy for me. There was no advice giving. It was a little low-budget horror film. I don't think there was any of that conversation. I think she was just happy I had a job. It's funny, you can look back on it and think that there's this great conversation, there isn't.
Because nobody knew at the time what a big deal it was gonna be.
It wasn't a big deal even when it first came out. That took a long time for it to catch on. It got some good reviews, but again, there was no internet, there was no, you know, how did you sell a horror movie? It was like a trailer and then an ad in the paper, and that was about it. I mean, it was a word of mouth response, for sure. People would say, ooh, did you see that?
Yeah. And it spawned an entire kind of subgenre of movies that wanted to be Halloween.
Yeah, but again, I was just in it. I wasn't a creator, I wasn't a writer, I was just an actor in the movie. And yes, it spawned something. I appreciate the fact that it spawned something. I understand that that's what happens.
Yeah.
But I don't take ownership for the spawning. Do you know what I mean? Like, it's what happened. It's just what happened. It's the nature of show-off business. Is something catches and then you try to replicate it, and then you can't, and then it, you know, it falls away.
Did you find it difficult?
Fog. Uh huh. Okay.
No, we have a picture.
No, that's from the fog. That may be from the fog.
And you then go into the next big role for you, I believe, is Trading Places.
Yes.
And that's a classic comedy, and it's also, I think, probably a surprise for people who only knew you from these two.
Well, movies. So here's the story. So since this is Halloween related, I didn't even this morning when I woke up, happy to be alive, know that I was coming to really a sort of farewell Halloween thing. So it's all good. I'm happy to, oh, look, there I am. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Here's what happened. When I say I owe my entire life to Laurie Strode, I owe my entire creative life to Laurie Strode. You may say, well, how does Laurie Strode affect Trading Places? I'm gonna tell you. I got a call from my agent saying that John Landis was doing a short documentary called Coming Soon about 1950s horror film trailers. Remember those crazy trailers that would say Coming Soon, and they were these sort of crazy scenarios? He was making a documentary about these horror film trailers, and he needed somebody to be the on-camera personality. Who do you think they called? The current Scream Queen, right? I get a call. I didn't know who John Landis was. I don't watch these movies. I'd never seen one of them. They brought me onto the backlot. They hired me. They paid me a little money. They brought me to the backlot. You can see it on YouTube. What I'm wearing, I still can't understand why they were like, yeah, that's good. It's like blue pants and a sweater, it's nasty. Anyway, and I narrate. You say, how much were the tickets? How much were the tickets?
$40.
You guys saved $40 each. I will take a 5% cut. And you can leave it with the doorman. Thank you. Oh, now there's six of you. Okay.
It's gonna be full pretty soon.
Yeah. Watch the entire audience.
I love you. you, Jamie!
Thank you. So what happened was, clearly, I'm this person when I'm working with John Landis doing the narration for these horror film trailers, which I did. And clearly, I'm this person during the breaks and, you know, and we worked for like 3 or 4 days on the back lot at Universal. So then when John was casting Trading Places, he said to Universal, I mean to Paramount, I want her. I went auditioned and he said, I want her. And they went, no. Remember, this is the female lead in a comedy with Eddie Murphy and Dan Aykroyd. Studio picture. And I know they said no. And John Landis said yes. And I am in Trading Places because of horror films and because John Landis had the courage to stand up to the studio and say, I want her. And whatever he saw, you know, off, you know, me cracking wise, say what? What happened?
Just let's just keep going.
Well, I don't know. What did he say? Something vulgar? Don't make me go out and...
Yeah, you don't want to be messing with Laurie Strode.
Yeah, seriously. Anyway, that's why I'm in Trading Places, because of John Landis. And then that movie just was a huge hit. And that gave me some street cred. And because of that movie, John Cleese wrote the part in Fish Called Wanda. And because of Fish Called Wanda, Jim Cameron wrote the part in True Lies. So the truth of the matter is, if I trace it back, all of my big successes are still directly related to Laurie Strode.
And you have this these absolute perfection, this movie.
Yes, it's fantastic.
And it runs at such a high level all the way through.
It's great.
It just keeps building and building and building.
Yep.
What was it like?
Again, you're gonna hate that. I had a child at that point.
I've written a movie for you and Arnold Schwarzenegger, and I would like you to read it.
Okay. But I can't send you the script because it's protected, but I can have my assistant drop it by and he'll wait and you'll read it and then get back. I said, okay, James Cameron, okay. Hang up, guy shows up, read the script. He and I meet the next morning. I'm like, okay. He says, great. That's how True Lies happened. That's how True Lies happened. The phone rang, it was James Cameron saying, I've written a movie for you.
That's gotta be pretty great.
That's awesome.
It was awesome. It was unbelievable.
So what kind of...
I'm telling you now, that's something that you didn't know today before you came here.
No, and it really is kind of amazing, because I remember the first time I saw that movie, I thought, that's the best looking interrogation room I've ever seen.
Exactly. And then the second thing that happened was I called the production manager. And I said, hi, it's Jamie Lee Curtis, I'm playing Helen. How far into the schedule is the scene in the hotel room? And he said, it's the second week. And I said, fuck, thank you. And then I stopped eating, because that was like 3 weeks, or like it was a month away. So that was the other thing that was a very, you know, that also happened, because that was shot in Santa Clarita on a set the second week of the movie.
And then I wanted to ask you about, since the clock is ticking, the Goldfinger.
We're fine, look at us. Oh my God, that's like 25 times more than they give you on the Today Show. Seriously, we have 16 minutes, we're gold.
The sequel's coming out soon.
The sequel of what?
Knives Out.
Oh, God, you scared me. I was like, the sequel of what?
Yes.
I scared Laurie Strode. That's a sin. Oh, no, there's... Look at this.
More of them. They're on the... They got the balcony.
Your fans. Word has gotten out.
The sequel is coming out. I'm going to the premiere on Monday night of The Glass Onion. I'm excited. Oh, yes, so fun. So great. Great. I was a replacement part, but great.
Really? Tell me about that.
I've been a replacement part a very successful replacement part a couple of times. I was a replacement part on Freaky Friday. That was like the week before shooting began. And I stepped into that part.
Which might be my favorite.
I believe I was also a replacement part here. Which is great. And what that means is that somebody else, it was written for somebody else.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Jamie. Happy birthday to you.
I wished that I would remember who I am. Right in this moment. Right where I am, right in this second. Thanks, you guys. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, genius.
Jamie, thank you.
So much for inspiration. Oh, and then there's a lady right here. There's a lady right here.
Okay. Thank you so much.
What do you want
in? Your summer wear.
Is that me?
Yes, that's you.
Be careful.
Hold on 1 second.
Thank you so much for all of like the love and caring for the flowers and care. The store was like beautiful.
It was beautiful.
I'm so thankful you came back.
Thank you.
I know.
What do you have?
Sure.
Oh, no, I just mean like it's a small item. Like you could,
thank you so much.
You could take this plaza. Like I said, she's going that way.
This apparently will get you in anywhere.
So Max, you're going to silver.
Jamie, you are the greatest. You know
yes,
that.
You are, Jamie. Thank you.
So much for inspiration. Oh, and then there's a lady right here. There's a lady right here.
Okay.
What do you
want in?
Your summer wear. Is that me?
Yes, that's you.
Be
careful.
Hold on
1 second.
Thank you so much for all of like the love and care and the store. It was like beautiful.
It was beautiful.
I'm so thankful you came back.
Thank you.
I know.
What do you have?
Sure.
Oh, no, I just mean like it's a small item that you could
see.
Wish I had you all alone, just the two of us. I would hold you close to me, so close to me.